between Kylie and Brandon. You came out to protest with us, and the rain threw off our whole day. Ended up leaving the arch. We went to the top, and
that's awesome.
But look, let me get in here and.
Awesome.
So, ladies and gentlemen, this is Kylie and Brandon, and.
Yep.
They are St. Louis and tactivists, and we're going to talk to them briefly. They have they've been running all around downtown looking for Bloodstained Men.
They're trying to find you guys.
They knew we were down here, so they were running around downtown. And Kylie, why don't you tell us how you finally found us?
Okay, so we originally had found you guys because I was pregnant with our first son, and you know, we were doing all that information on the circumcision and whether or not we were going to circumcise because he was circumcised. And we decided, after all, you know, it's torture. It's upsetting, it's sad. Nobody should do that to their son, you know? And I was never going to do that. After I did the research, as soon as I found out how sad and horrible that was, it is not necessary. There's no reason to do that to your son. He is perfect, whole, you know, and to take that away from him, he should have the right to, you know, decide whether he wants to do that one day.
Right, when
that's
he grows
what
up.
He wants to do.
And okay. You guys are awesome. You got the knowledge and information.
He is four.
He's four. And,
yes.
And do you have another son also?
Nope. Only one son. So, and he's perfect. He's intact. He's so happy.
Brandon, was it a shock to you when you learned?
It was a definite shock. I'm 25 years old. And, you know, I never gave a second thought about it growing up. I never had that information. You know, I never thought about
it. It's a family secret.
That's
true.
Parents
do not tell their sons.
Right, that's true.
And we know that they deliberately hide it from their sons. I don't know if you saw my post or the post the other day, but a bus driver in the bus system in the public schools in Cape Girardeau, they actually rerouted their buses so the school kids would not see it. So,
oh,
I mean, it's
wow.
Parents are deliberately hiding this from their sons.
Yeah, you guys out here today with, you know, boots on the ground, it's a wake-up call to the kids, parents, everybody.
Tell our viewers about the shock that you went through when did you have to fight about it? Was it hard getting through to
I had people that told me that I should circumcise my son because, you know, that's routine. Everybody does it. And once I saw that video, I cried to see somebody.
Yeah, that open in the hospital and all the information.
It's so heartbreaking to see a baby cry.
We've been together for 10 years, so as soon as we researched it, you know, We were together at the same time.
So you didn't go through a period
of
denial.
No arguing.
It was all, we both had
I'm open-minded, so as soon as I got the information, it was a no-brainer for me. It's not natural. You know, all man was the one with the foreskin.
Yes.
And, you know, you go across seas like England and whatnot, it's not normal over there.
No, not at all.
Over here in America, it's a way for them to make money off you. They want to, you know, spill the myths and lies and... You know, they
say
want to
it's
scare
cleaner,
people.
Then, you know, it's not. There's a reason why everyone is born with a foreskin.
And are you having success with your friends, relatives, neighbors?
Yes, I have. I have talked to several people that has changed their mind about circumcising.
And Brother K, your help too. We have people on our Facebook friends list. You know, they got little boys. They're undecided. We tag you. You get on Facebook. You help us out. You know, you give them information. And, you know, just like that, they're on our board too.
Wow.
So you're changing a lot of lives and you're helping a lot of people.
Wow.
You and the Bloodstained Men. You guys are doing it together.
It's amazing. I love it so
much. And, you know, we have the group called Friends of Bloodstained Men, which you're probably in.
Yep, we're in there.
And you can invite your friends to join that. And there's also another good page, Your Whole Baby Community for Learning.
Okay.
Wow,
if you meet parents that are on the fence or have questions.
I have a friend right now that's pregnant with her third son, and I really want to
And we're going to definitely give her the knowledge.
Her mind, you know?
She has two cut sons.
Yes. I'm pretty sure.
And as you know, there are a lot of regret moms that do not cut subsequent sons.
Yeah, we hear about it all the time.
Definitely. Mm-hmm. And I know that I could change her mind. I know I could.
Good.
I've changed
some
people's minds.
It's a no-brainer. Yeah. You know, if you have a heart, and you know you're carrying your newborn son. It's
a
no-brainer.
That's your flesh and blood. You want to protect that. Why would you hand them over to a doctor that would hurt them and mutilate them and torture them? You know, it's not right.
You know, baby girls are protected in USA. They're federally protected, and for little boys, you know, to not have the same, you know, standards, that's horrible.
It is. It's very sad.
You guys are really convincing, and I think you're very effective.
We try.
We are. We're
not too good on camera, but we're trying.
You're really good.
I am very
camera.
Passionate
you're getting,
about it.
You're getting
I
a lot
it.
Of heart reactions here on camera. And
thank you.
Thank you.
Brandon, you know, 6-7 years ago when I started my work on Facebook, I would hear all the time, well, if circumcision is so bad, how come men aren't complaining about it? Oh. Well, American men are standing up, speaking out, and thank you for adding your voice to this struggle, because it's a struggle.
You're welcome.
You don't want your son grow up in a society that will try to shame him, or where he may marry a woman that will say she wants to cut your grandson. You don't want your grandson to be cut. This is a struggle for the future of our children.
Yeah, we got the family involved, and my nephew, he's going on 18 years old, and he's on board too. He wanted to come down here today, but he couldn't get a chance. But he's jealous now. He said, "Brother Kay, I want to go see him." And the fact that he's a part of the younger generation and his eyes are open.
See, you know, you're getting through to a lot of people, all the hearts. And ladies and gentlemen, thank you for those hearts across the screen. Those touch our hearts here on the street when we're talking to people, because this is a grassroots, all volunteer struggle. We are up against a powerful medical establishment that has entrenched interests, conflicts of interest, I should say. Financial, ideological, and religious, and you follow my page, you know what I'm saying.
We're going to beat it.
And you know what? Is. There's a reason why there's so many men with erectile dysfunction, you know. When you get circumcised and you live every day with rubbing your glands on your, you know, on your underwear, there's a reason why.
Let me tell you, yesterday on the front lines in
Fairview Heights,
a man came up. This is all he said. Well, this was his opening statement. Could circumcision have anything to do with ED?
It does.
Yes.
And this was a middle-aged man.
Absolutely. The foreskin is a vital function. You know, we're mammals. It's there for a reason. Like our eyelids, it's there to protect our eyes, you know? The human body is made for a reason, and everything's vital.
Brandon, what do you say to American doctors? You know more about male sexuality and anatomy than American doctors do.
That's true.
What do you say to those guys and women that are cutting these babies?
I say...
No, I hate you guys.
Back off.
Stop pushing
your opinion. It's not science, it's your opinion. It's, you know, 100 years of myths and folklore. And even when we had our baby at St. Clair, she has a story for you.
They said, "You're not going to circumcise your son." They told me that. You're not going to circumcise.
Yeah, they were pushing it on us.
I said, "No, I will not circumcise my son." They wanted to push it on me.
And here are the hearts. You can see. Yeah. You're both very effective. You're a great couple,
their
too.
Their opinion on me.
Yep. First day in there, they wanted to push it.
10 years together.
Two days later, they said, "You're not going to circumcise."
No.
So I'm freaking out. And every hour that passed, I'd remind them, We're not going to circucise.
I even reported the nurse.
It was like the norm, you know?
So she said it several times.
She told me that I needed to circumcise my son.
Yeah.
She wanted me to, and I said, "No, I will not." And she just would not let it go. We got another
We got dirty looks and whatnot, but we know what's right for our son. That's our baby, you know?
Wow.
Yeah, we're going to welcome him to the world with love, you know, not a knife.
Wow. That individual should have been put on trial for solicitation of unnecessary surgery, and that person should have served jail time and issued you a public apology. That is disgraceful.
And God forbid, if we didn't have the knowledge, we think it's wrong. The second time, we probably would have.
Are you going to circumcise your son?
And you can see the hearts, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for all those hearts flowing across the screen for Kylie and Brandon.
Thanks for the love, and Brother K's out here, boots on the ground, and. Knowledge is power, guys.
Man, I wish we would have made it here sooner. Yeah. I would love to stand in the crowd with you guys. Yeah.
This is what you were describing to me, the transportation problems getting here, and also the rain. The rain was really nasty.
It was.
Yeah, that's true. But it was all worth it, though.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to say goodbye now to Kylie and Brandon.
All right,
thank you so much for joining us on this live broadcast.